Hey guys, this is Ilya coming to you from the Wartune test server, and in patch 6.1 we see some additions to the tattoo system. I think it's called the tattoo engraving system, or at least that's probably what we're going to call it. And I jumped the gun a little bit and did some, but I don't think that really takes away from me showing what's going on here. So what we need are these tattoo engraving stones, and each time we use one of those stones, we're going to either gain a star or subtract a star. And also this thing in the center changes. So with 2 stars, we're at level 2 and my tattoo charisma is plus 10%. And so that just means that whatever gains I make, obviously on the test, I mean on my own server, I definitely need to make this intelligence or else I'm not going to get any gains from this tattoo engraving system. But anyway, so we just click on that and hopefully get some stars out of it. But there definitely is a risk to losing stars. And I'm wondering if this blessing cost, changes that so that you guarantee that you're going to get a positive star. I was a little bit confused. The success rate is in white, and then when you click on this, it's in green. So I don't know. I wouldn't believe this success rate 100% if you're not paying up Balin's. But of course, I think it's probably better to just try and collect up as many of these stones as possible to do this. And so the only problem about this is that the ways you get these stones are a little bit difficult. I would definitely take it easy for now because the exchangeable source that I'm seeing is only through Outland Contest, and so Outland Contest has changed quite a bit. If I don't have a video out about this yet, I would definitely will, so look around for that. But the Wild Shop has these, basically we can use Outland Crystals for it. So here are the tattoo engraving stones. It costs 1500 Outland Crystals for just one of these. And so you're going to want to collect up at least a few in order before you do anything with these. But that's also competing with smelting stones. And so I think smelting stones in general are going to be much, much more valuable, especially early on, because smelting is huge. I mean, you gain so much BR from your equipment from smelting stones that I think it's a little bit difficult to compete with that and instead commit so many crystals over to engraving stones. So the other place that you can get engraving stones is by doing explorations. And again, I talk about all of this in the video about the new additions to Outland Contest. But basically you go into these areas and you explore them, and there are treasure thieves, and those treasure thieves have a chance at getting one of these engraving stones. So I think that that's probably the best way to go about it, is to just try and get those treasure thieves. The treasure thieves have a chance at either 100 Outland Crystals, or an engraving stone, or possibly other stuff that I haven't seen, but those are the two items I've seen. And so going after those, you can get some engraving stones and possibly work up this tattoo engraving. But I think, at least for now, unless your smelt equipment is quite high, it's probably not worth going after this, because a percentage gain to your tattoos is probably not as good as a percentage gain to your equipment. But anyway, I don't know. Maybe if all your tattoos are intelligence like mine, and you get an addition to your intelligence, maybe it's actually better. But I think in general, smelt equipment is a good way to go. It's a very balanced way of improving your stats. Alright, so let's go ahead and do some of this. I have plenty of engraving stones. This is a very unrealistic number for you to obtain on the normal server, so obviously it's the test server. I'm able to go through a lot of this and see how far we can push it. But let's just do this without using this blessing cost, and then maybe change it if we feel like we want to try something else. So now each time it goes up by 5%, and so this one is improving my endurance. It doesn't look like there's any subtraction or anything like that. Still endurance. And still improving. So, okay, so the success rate is going down as I use this. And, okay, so yeah, the blessing cost definitely improves the rate to 100%. So the early ones you don't have to worry about. Oh, I got intelligence. That's nice. Let's see what my tattoos look like. So that green number is saying, you know, what's being improved. Okay, so plus 5,000 intelligence is no joke. That's quite a bit. That's like, yeah, okay, that's a lot. That's 20,000, 20,000 plus magical attack. So that's absolutely no joke. If you're all intelligence tattoos, that would be even crazier. I could change these over, but we might as well just leave it alone. And so, okay, never mind. This might actually be a lot better than smelt equipment. Well, I don't know. Smelt equipment is so nice because you bump everything up. Everything's improving all at the same time. But even so, this is huge, especially at the later stuff. But anyway, let's keep going. This first one, okay, I lost one. Let's keep going. Grave successfully. Alright, so even at an 80% success rate, we're not doing that great. There's the intelligence. 35%. Up to plus 6,000 intelligence. Ugh, a lot of failures. I think I'm gonna try and fill this up and just see how many engraving stones I've used. And the even bigger problem is getting which one you want. So, this might be tough. 25%. Oh, that's so much magical attack. Come on. Killing me here. It's a 60% success rate here, and I feel like we've done this many, many times. So I think this rate is genuinely lying. Alright, so then we maxed out, and we also have, let's see here, success rate, oh, it's still down. Okay, and we got intelligence, which is very nice, so that's a 50% increase, so that's really, really quite a bit of intelligence increase to your tattoos. My magical attack is skyrocketing. So I think we can move on to this one, so losing stars out of here is gonna be sad, but, successful. How do I... Oh, I have to click on it. Oh, darn, okay. That was really stupid. Okay, so I have to go back through here. I am so dumb. It kills me. Alright, so definitely do not click on this if you've already finished one of these. Very lucky that I have this many materials. Alright, and it's the wrong one. And I had it all right the first time. These success rates are 100% lying to you. I think I've clicked on these enough times each one to like know the rate, and this is not looking promising. Not when I'm dipping back down to like 4 stars on an 80% success rate. That's terrible. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna use this blessing cost. Obviously I have balance to kill on the test server, but on the main server you're not gonna want to do this. Alright, we got intelligence here. I'm gonna move over to this one. Maybe you have to max out this one? Is that what happened? How we unlock this guy? Not totally sure. Okay, you just have to do anything to one of these and the next one unlocks. So that's good to know. So you can actually, it's probably a better idea, like, let's get this one to something useful. Okay, so defense is a little bit better. And then we can go on to this one. Well, that's pretty nice. So, really, you don't want to be working towards big stars on this one. What you really want to do is just open up a lot of them and see what you can get, because the success rates go down. So, I don't think it's that hard to get, like, 5% of something that you like in every single one of these. So, that said, I think you can get, like, plus 20% intelligence over 4 of these engravings pretty easily. Or for the physical attack classes, go with strength, and so that's going to be quite nice, actually. So maybe, again, like smelting stones, the early levels, it's not going to be much, and you can go after them, and so maybe if you're struggling to get enough smelting stones for the next level, switch over to engraving stones, but I think it's probably better to just take it easy, because it's not looking promising for these late stars. Maybe try and get, people are gonna be pretty sad if they keep getting charisma ones. So there's another intelligence. So you just sort of work your way around. Oh, and the engraving stone cost is, so that is the kicker. So the engraving stone cost for this one is 4. And for this one, it's 3, and for this one, it's 2. For this guy, it's 1. So you do have to weigh things a bit by, so this one, you're not going to want to do a lot. You'll probably get the first star or two and just be satisfied with that until you get a lot more stars over here. And same for once you fill this up, this guy. So, still, a learning process. This is the first time I've looked at it, but just from what I can tell, it's gonna take a while to build this stuff up, unless there are big cashier events to get a lot of these materials. But yeah, you definitely have to be careful of these costs. Those are no joke, but that's about it. I mean, I guess I could flip through this and try and max out everything. But even so, let's just look at this for now. This is 50, plus 30 is 80, another 110%, 140%. So with 140% gain, I get 24,000 or so more intelligence. So my magical attack, whatever it was well under 800k before. So I just gained some absurd amount of magical attack. So we're gonna, the attack stats you're going to see are even crazier, and so I think what I'm gonna go ahead and do is just max these out. So I'll zip through this part of the video, but we'll just see what it looks like having capped out this engraving system, because God knows I have enough materials for it. Alright, you guys, so I maxed out everything, and got them all into intelligence. So some of these I was, I had to go through again because they weren't at the stat that I wanted, and I'm sort of surprised, actually. I mean, if you think about it, I started out with 10,000 of these engraving stones, so I've used less than 1,200 in order to max out all of these. Which, considering any material, yes, it's very, very difficult to obtain these engraving stones in large quantities, so that's not a trivial task, but as far as just maxing out anything in this game with 1,200 of a material is pretty unheard of, especially the fact that I didn't use any, I only used this blessing cost once, and it was on one of these guys, so at worst, you're tacking on another 30 engraving stones. Which I think sits us right around using 1,200 of these to cap these all out. So yes, it's a difficult material to get, but I think this might be somewhat doable over an extended period of time. Again, the drops from Outland are a little bit limited, so when you go into these explorations, definitely go after the treasure thieves. I think there's a much higher chance that you get 100 Outland crystals, but there is a chance to get one of those stones. And you know, smelt equipment is quite tough once you start getting into the higher levels, but the smelt equipment also goes very, very high. So, I mean, you really need to collect up a lot of these stones. You know, maybe at some point I can do sort of like a comparison blog post for, you know, when maybe it becomes more cost effective to switch over to engraving stones instead of smelting stones. But the early levels of smelting, I think for sure are overall going to be better. But that's it for the tattoo engraving system. So you guys get to see the full extent of it already, and the only thing that I don't have are max tattoos on the test server, so I don't have enough advanced henna to do that. I think this is all the henna I have on this server. So on the main server, we're gonna see people with completely maxed out tattoos getting some of these bonuses, and it's gonna be pretty crazy. I mean, I don't expect to see anybody be able to do this on the main server yet, but they will have better tattoos, and we're gonna see some big numbers. So anyway, that's it for this portion of the patch 6.1 preview. For sure, check out the blog, the rest of the YouTube channel, and stay up to date on our Facebook page for all the info on patch 6.1. Thanks for watching, you guys. Take care and have a very good day.